Hello and welcome along. Today on Cobra Park Farm, we are going to be working on Field 8. We have our cultivator and we have our T6 because our T7 is out ploughing Field 7. So we use our T6 for cultivating this field here, which is Field 8, which is the field we're working on this week. So without further ado, let's jump in and get started. So you can see just down there, our T7 working away, having finished work on here last episode. Whoop. So ideally, I would like to have had the T8 on this, but we do need that to be ploughing. So fortunately, not. So we are going to turn that 90 degrees, unfold this, and auto it. Okay. So it needs to come across a little bit. And away we go. So my hope is that we can get through this episode. I don't see why not. It's a slightly quicker process than the ploughing was. And as a result, we should be able to get this done quicker. If not, I'll be very surprised. There we go again. Ooh. Those who missed that, that was the wrong button. So the T6 is actually handling this cultivator quite nicely. I thought it might struggle. I was worried it was going to struggle a little bit. But we seem to have picked the right size cultivator to run on the farm that this will handle. Which is fantastic. Oh, we're not. Yeah, just... did not have the GPS set then. That could have been a little bit disastrous. But we're alright. This can be at times be a very big field. So I'm wondering, I'm trying to think what it is we're going to plant in here. It'll be a little while before the next episode. So, please drop in the comments, what should we plant in this field? What crop should we have in field 8? Because that is what we will be planting in here next episode. I'd love to know your thoughts on this. I'd love to know what you think we should grow here. Because this is, yeah. This is the VFN. This is the Virtual Farming Network. And I am Virtual Farmer. And you're all part of it, so, you know, please let me know. What should we have in this field? Oh. We are miles off course there. There we go. Because this will be nice and fallow and ready to plant. It needs to be, just as a caveat to that, it needs to be some sort of grain. So something that we can plant with our existing planter. So, sorry, no root crops. So no sugar beet, no potatoes, and no... poplars either, because at the moment we don't have the ability to plant those, and we don't have the money to try and get them planted either, unfortunately. As much as I'd like to, as much as I want to do poplars at some point, I think our most likely map for that is going to end up being Lostburg at the moment. I think if I do that, we're also going to have a massive maize harvest. A massive corn harvest. And grab a load of chaff and... yeah, and do that. How are we on timing? We are maybe a third of the way through the field, and we are about a third of the way through our time, so that's promising. With any luck, that will continue to hold. And we can get this field cultivated this episode. Of course, doing this as realistically as I can within the game. I really like doing fields this way, actually. I like doing... doing my headlands last and trying to judge the correct distance I'll need to do it, and yeah, I very much like that. The GPS does make this a bit easier, I'll admit. matter of fact. We're gonna get rid of the lines. And I might take a couple more screenshots. I do take an awful lot of screenshots in an episode. Except for those episodes where I forget to take them. Yeah. When I forget to take them, then I'm going, oh no, what did I do? Why did I forget to do that? Because then I got to try and scramble to somehow get a screenshot. Tractors could also really do with the clean. We do have enough money at the moment for me to buy a pressure washer, actually. But this tractor is going to be doing lots more of this. So I'm not sure washing it quite yet is what we're after. End of the planting season, we might. I'm hoping our 8340 is going to be able to pull the planter. Otherwise, we're going to be quite delayed on getting everything done. T7 is, yeah, it's still at the bottom of the hill. You can see it there. So that's going to be some time getting that done. Unfortunately, not going to be done by the time we finish this episode, I don't think. We're almost halfway through both the episode and the field, so that's good. It's keeping going. I'm enjoying this setup of you know, trying to. I'm just concentrating on one field for the videos for a week. So, or until that field is sort of done through one cycle of its growing setup. Because we did it a bit with field 8. Where we did the harvest and the baling and then loaded up the bales and all of that. Field 7. And now we're doing the same with field 8. So we're going through the entire planting preparation and planting cycle of it. And I'm enjoying that. And I hope you guys are as well. So, what do you think? Do you think this is a good way of doing things? Are you enjoying this way of doing things? Sort of doing, just concentrating on a single field for several episodes. There we go. And away we go again. So yeah, this is the halfway point. And yeah, field day is a good size field to be doing this kind of thing on. It's not too big. And we can cover it in about an episode. I'm guessing that heavy duty is slipping on a tree. We'll just go check it. Oh no. Not on a tree. It looks like course plate fouled up a bit. Yeah, course plate fouled up a bit. There we go. Right. And set. And down. Yeah, course play sometimes has issues like that. I'm slightly surprised, but... it's almost as if it got to the end and decided it was going completely the wrong direction. And then did a big circle. Hopefully it's not going to continue to have that problem. If it does, I might have to abandon course plate for a bit until a more stable version comes out. At the moment, it's doing okay, but it's still a little rough around the edges. Definitely doesn't work with the tractors. They have massive issues with it. Which is why Clown Tour has been fouling up on Chellington when using a trailed cultivator. Yeah, we are set. It's good. Might end up doing it into the in-game evening, this. But that's okay. Right, and... of course, the downside to this, I've just thought, is I know I've asked everybody what I should plant on here, but we may get the update tomorrow, which is Friday. You guys are watching this on Monday, but or this is released on Monday, but I'm recording this on the previous Thursday. So we may get the game update tomorrow. If we do, of course, all the work we're doing at the moment is for Nout, as all these fields will be reset. Which is mightily annoying. So we'll see. Hopefully I won't lose things like all the bales that I've done as well, because that would be massively annoying. There we go. So we have, yeah, we've got the smaller part of the field to do. We may have delayed ourselves slightly by sorting out the issue with the T7. Which is not helpful, but we will soldier on. We will get this field done. And we will move on from there. Right, so we're back to doing a smaller part of the field. We're looking for quick turnarounds now in order to make sure that we get as much of this field done in this episode as possible. Well, especially as we're, now that we're pulling uphill a little bit, we've slowed. Yeah. So downhill we're fine, but we're now doing some of this a little bit uphill. Way back. That is going to be a spectacular view. There we go. As always, we need to do a little bit of in-cab in a moment. Right, we've got to avoid the telegraph pole this time. Right, so we'll work our way around it. There we go. Expertly done. Oh no. Would say that then. There we go. Expertly done. Go again. There's some of the sort of feeling I had with yesterday's episode where I'm seeing the time and going, oh no, there's not enough time to finish this field. We'll be okay. It's Yeah. I don't know why time suddenly runs away in the second half of this field. I think it must be something to do with the uphill bit. Well, I wouldn't give some head tracking. That would be amazing in cab. Head tracking in a wheel. Alright, let's see if we can't position this right. How's that? That's actually pretty good. I'm happy with that. I'd love to put some music on the radio in this, but I would get a copyright claim, so I can't. I do like, when I went on the rare occasions where I do get to just play rather than recording or streaming, I do like to have the radio on. It's it is quite nice in here. There we go. Again, how did that look? Ah, that's not bad at all. Seem to be judging that okay. Which is amazing for in-cab when I didn't look backwards. Right, so round, and we want to do it about here. Perfect. I'm happy with that. Yeah. So we'll do that. So that allows us just to check quickly exactly where we're putting the plow, cultivator down. While we do this last little bit of the field. So it would help if I press the right button to lift the cultivator. Away we go again. Oh yeah, well there's just this last little bit of the field down here. Before I attack the headlands. Yep, that's all nicely lined up. Good starting position. This is going to be a nicely cultivated field. Yeah, one of the downsides of course play at the moment, not showing the tractor on the map. So I can't tell what the progress of the T7 is. And away we go again. It's not beyond the this map's update coming out. There's not a lot happening in Farm Sim at the moment. I'm just trying to think of stuff that that I can cover, and there isn't an awful lot. It's with the new year having happened. It's kind of almost like we're waiting for a DLC or waiting for some more information to come out. It's possible that something might come out, of course, between me recording this and it going live. There's almost certainly going to be some new mods tomorrow, which is, for me, is Friday. Yeah, almost certainly going to be some new mods to check out. But in general, yeah, there's not a lot. There are a couple of nice mods that have come out recently. So there's the Class Jaguar mod. That is the Forage Harvester. That's a fantastic looking mod. I want to get my hands on that and get that on this map actually. Because I think that's a growing up, that was always the one you saw. If you ever saw a forage harvester in the UK, it was always a class one. For, I don't know what reason. But yeah, always saw a class one, never saw anything else. So, that's why I want to get a class on here. And that I think will be a massive field of a couple of big fields of corn, and then a field of poplars as well. Maybe. I think if I have a forage harvester, I need to take full advantage of it. And so that's not doing a one crop thing, that's doing the full whack. Okay, we have almost come to the end of this, I think, looking at this. Yep. So we're going to head round the headlands now. Get these done. It should mean that we get the field finished in the episode, which will make me very happy. Okay, it's going to be a slightly longer episode as a result, but we're so close to finishing. I can't help but do all the headlands on this, I think. One thing I should probably note is I think that that the cedar we have on this actually has a built-in cultivator. I think it's one of those. I think it's a direct seed, so we didn't have to really do this, I think. But I like to be thorough. I like to cultivate my fields before I seed them. Only rarely do I do the direct seed. Or go the direct seed route. Right, so we're going to have to reverse back up here and get this second line. Yeah, so reverse back. And there we go. It's a little bit wider than our cultivator. What we have left along here. We have to head back down here in a minute, I think. Oh, there are 3 rows worth down this side anyway. To get this headland done. There we go. This we seem to have got about right. Is good. Well, our T7 is making its way up the hill. Don't think it's far off the tree. I'll keep an eye on that. Making some interesting misses. It's got to be something to do with the hill, that. Because we had a similar issue over here. So I think I'm going to have a load of clearing up to do with the T7. But for now, we are almost finished on our headlands. It's going to be our longest episode for a little while, this. But we will finish this field. Right, so one last trip to do. We'll get that. Excuse me. We'll get that sorted. And up. There we go. So, step out and under the shade of this tree. All that remains, really, is for me to say thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. Please give it a like. drop us a comment and give it a share. And for all the latest videos from Virtual Farmer, please subscribe to the channel. I will see you next time. Goodbye.